my yacht. She was known in the town.
Miss Lillie, I'm really so sorry to intrude like this, but really it's my duty. I have to tell you. You see, off there we have been selecting straws, drawing them as
and,
to who
would... I won.
Oh, you see, yes. She got the best straw.
She won.
Naturally, that would entitle her to recite now. Mm-hmm. And incidentally, when I say she, I mean Miss Louise Fazenda. You'll pardon me. I think you should know each other. Miss Fazenda, this is Miss Lillie.
How do you do?
This is my place.
Right here. You'd naturally recite it right there.
There once was a quaint little Quaker called Jane. In her taffeta dress, she looked perfectly sweet. She wasn't a beauty, and though she was plain, her figure attracted all eyes in the street.
Now, that is ducky. I enjoyed every minute of that.
My yacht.
Miss Lillie, again, I must come forth and stop you. You see, in the selection of the straws, I happen to be the second one to win. Therefore, I would recite now.
Naturally.
You'll excuse me. Mm-hmm. This is a little thing that came to me in the middle of the night.
I beg your pardon.
I say this is a thing that came to me in the middle of the night.
Too late.
I won't lose my temper. Mm. The title of this poem is A Jockey's Lament.
Mm?
It has something to do with a jockey. It's a shame she'll never be fancied again. She's putting on weight and she's gone in the feet. When she jumped, you could see it was a terrible strain. She's old and she's fat and she does nothing but eat. Hey, hey. Did you catch on to that last part? I just kind of sneaked
Bravo.
That in.
My yacht. She was known in the town.
Miss Lillie, would you think I was Detro?
Yes.
If I told you, you're still not in turn. A gentleman on the end asleep, I think. No, Mr. Hamilton. That's Mr. Lloyd Hamilton. You've probably heard of him. He's of international fame. He has the third chance to recite. And incidentally, I'd like to have you meet him, Miss Lillie.
Mr. Hamilton.
I haven't seen you around for some time. You look well. About there would be good. And incidentally, ladies, I'd like to tell you that Mr. Hamilton is really a remarkable reciter.
Shucks, it's really nothing. My new car. Her body is painted in purple and white. She started out finely, but when she was in reverse, the wind blew off her bonnet and it traveled from out of sight. It looked as if something was going to burst.
I want to be the first to congratulate you.
My yacht. She was known in the town as the Sailor's Delight. I could see she was broad in the beam from the first. I knew I was in for a pretty thick night, so I slackened her stays and prepared for the worst.
That is the finish of your
Yes,
poem.
That's the end.
Well, I don't know. It's just my own personal opinion, but I think the whole thing is a little short. I mean, we're not getting any place. If we all got together and recited all of our poems together.
Yes, I'll start.
I wish you would.
There once was a quaint little Quaker called Jane.
It's a shame she'll never be fancied again.
Her body was painted in purple and white.
She was known in the town as the Sailor's Delight. In her taffeta gown, she looked perfectly sweet.
She's putting on weight, and she's gone in the feet.
She started out finely. When she reversed?
I could see she was broad in the beam from the first. She wasn't a beauty, but though she was plain.
When she jumped, you could notice it was a terrible strain.
Her bonnet blew off when it vanished in sight.
I knew I was in for a pretty thick night. Her figure attracted all eyes in the street.
She's old and she's fat and she does nothing but eat.
Looked as if something was going to bust.
So I slackened her stays and prepared for the worst.
Your mother and my mother too. We're angels who part
I wish I had a girl.
And E for Littler Nick Licorice. Gee whiz, I can't go on.
And R stands for our Navy.
Oh, hear those cannons roar.
Put them all together.